Hello guys, welcome back to some more urban design on City Skylines. Now, from last episode, I can't tell you what I remember that we were doing because it has been a while. So, we'll just see what we can do for now. We don't have very much demand for, well, anything. Everything is very low demand. So, we'll just go and see what we can do in terms of cleaning up the city. There are any issues currently going on? Oh yes, straight away I can see there's an issue over here on this highway ramp. And why is this highway ramp an issue? Because the trucks are not getting in fast enough. That's the issue. Okay, but I can solve that fairly quickly by changing these roads up. By making these only one way. So I'm forcing all the trucks to go across the bridge and then start making their way around. Yeah, that will work. Hopefully. This interchange is a bit busy. I'm thinking, because ever since we created the connection with the tunnel around over here, which goes straight through the mountain, it's a quick shortcut to get to this exit point over here. And it's causing us some issues. Let's just quickly fix this. Got an area that we need to fix. Just push that across over here so that we're connected with water. With more demand. Oi! Congratulations, we've reached our next goal, which is 42,000, and we've got airports unlocked. Excellent. And what's the next goal? 55,000, and we unlock monuments and all areas to unlock. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay. How is this still going? It's starting to flow in, has little moments. Okay, this has got to be fixed. First, let's just, actually I think I remember what we were doing. We're filling all of this with industry. I think that's what we were doing. So, this area is flowing, but it's going a bit strange. It has little moments. I mean, look at the build-up. The build-up that comes from here is ridiculous. Trucks that want to leave do leave, but I'm just not sure if this ramp is a good idea. I believe this ramp might have to be modified. Yeah, it's just constantly getting clogged up. This helps a little bit, but not enough. Because now, now there's a clockage. There's going to be backup over here with what I've done. So, no, that's not going to work. We have to change these streets back to what they were. Like that. And essentially what I can do is perhaps make another on-ramp onto the other, to the other side of this map. I mean, to this, into this industry area. And the best way to do that would be through going through the other side. Give me a second, I'll think about this. Now, I believe that if it's going to happen... Yeah, now this area is getting clogged up really badly. before it was flowing, now it's slowing down. So what we're gonna have to do is think of a way to make this go through. Able to squeeze it in somewhere over here? No, I don't think so. Well, there we go. There was a spot right there. Well, that's not too bad. Somewhere from over here, I think. A little tiny bit straight and see what we can do. Can we join this up? No, we can't. So let's just push this across a little bit further. This as well, just a tiny bit further. And now that should be enough space to be able to create a 90 degree angle. It's not exactly 90 degrees, but still gonna have to find a way to make it look as if it's 90 degrees. So just push it out to there. Push this out to here, too far. Out to there, not too far still. I think we can work with that. I'll just make this go down by one click to go to its maximum length and a little straight segment and join up right there. Just change the direction. All right, so we've got another on-ramp into this area. Hopefully that will help. Oh, look at this. This area has cleared up now. Okay. Now this area is absolutely chockers. Alright, well, it's flowing, so I guess that's good. Still have more demand, so let's just chuck all this zone in. I'm hoping this can clear itself up pretty quickly too. There's no vehicles here. Oh, there's vehicles entering through here now, so that's good. So this ramp is starting to function. I can see this potentially being very problematic though. Hopefully it won't be though. We just have to see. This is flowing, so this should clear up pretty quickly, I hope. Now there's a big break before anyone comes from this direction, from straight up ahead. So that should clear up quite a few trucks back into this area. It's a good funneling service. And this still isn't being problematic, so that's good. A lot of traffic in between here. This area is clearing up now. This area is clear. This area is Perfect. All right, so I think that extra little ramp has kind of diverged enough trucks for now for us to be able to get away with. That's gonna burn down. No way is this fire truck gonna make it. That's already completely burnt. This traffic is just crazy. These ramps are just have their little moments. But the general dispersion of them is not too bad. They seem to be doing the job well enough. Yeah, fire truck didn't make it. Middle ramp is being used more than the outer ramp or exit, and I'm thinking perhaps it might be a smart idea to add another exit point. First, let's say we still need more industry, so okay, more industry it is. I think I can make a nice little cul-de-sac over here actually. Just extend this out, have some more space for business. Okay. And fill all of this up. Yeah, these ramps are just not funneling enough now. This industry area has just gotten a little bit too big. So what I might have to do is make another offshoot or exit ramp. The on ramps are fine. Now the off ramps are the problem, but maybe it'll clear itself out because we had a very large amount of trucks that entered into this area, but it seems to have fixed itself up, and now that all the trucks are in here, they're trying to get out and there's just not enough. So hopefully this will clear itself out, all these trucks will get out, and it will stop creating so many problems. But we'll have to wait and see. Let's just increase the simulation speed a little bit. Let's see what happens. So things are getting through now. If it leads to it, I'll get rid of this connection and just make two separate ramps, and then the trucks will specifically have to go to the right ramp. Oh well, it's going, it's flowing. These trucks are now starting to pour through. It was just a little moment, I reckon. Sometimes you have a large influx of trucks entering and then some exiting, and it just depends, but still, you need to make a road service that can handle whenever that happens. And at the moment, as you can see, we don't exactly have that on the exit ramp system, because essentially we only have one, because we've got two that exit, but they meet up together, so it eventually ends up being one because they all meet each other. And that's exactly what we're having again now. A little bit of a blockage, but everything over here is clearing up. And this is an oil industry. We need to extend this, yes. Oh, yay, yay. We now extend our oil industry. There we go. That's all the wrong industry. Alright. Now these buildings industry will have to change over. Thought there for a second it was looking a bit wrong. Yeah, I think we might need, yeah, we're definitely gonna have to work on another ramp. Or what we will do is just extend this one. And then the trucks will have to make their own way to the specific ramp that they want to go to. So let's just give that a shot. Let's just remove these trees and this connection. And I'll make a nice straight section over here. Actually, first let's see how far this... no, that should be able to connect without any issues. So I'll just connect it up, move it out to here. Push this out to there and connect. Change the direction of that. And now let's see what we've got. Now the trucks will definitely have to take their own specific exit point from within the industry area. It'll all just depend which way they want to go now. And from the looks of things, it looks like they prefer to take the loop. There's a couple taking the long way. Let's just remove some of these buildings that have no electricity. Oh, what I need to do is just... Yeah, that's bad. These buildings will eventually... The demand will eventually come. So what I'll need to do is just remove all of this again. All of this. All of that. All of this. And that. And start again by slowly expanding this area out. And let's just remove that as well. And let's just wait for this area to start building through. Alright, this should clear up the exits. Should be less problems now. Hopefully. Oi, now this ramp is going crazy. Look at that. This on-ramp is now being overused. How is this ramp being used? Yeah. This is the problem with this ramp now. So I'm just going to remove this for now. I don't need it. Find yourself another way to get there. Please. A lot of trucks coming in through here and using this as a shortcut. It's not essentially what I really want. So affecting the traffic here. So what I need to do is modify this. Yep. But then the trucks will not be able to come from... Yeah, this ramp is just too close to here. It's affecting this. So what needs to be done is another ramp over here that won't affect this ramp so much, the connection point. So just make a nice straight section, join that up over here, push this forward out to here, and make a nice straight section over here, and let's just join this up over here to there if we can. Now I have to make this connect over here somehow and make an off connection from the top of this. So just normal off connection then. If we can fit one in. It's only if we can fit one in. Which I think is going to be very difficult. From here. Where can we fit a off ramp? Yeah. Perhaps, yes. Right, sorry, but I'm going to remove that for a second. I'm going to remove this connection just for a second as well. I'm going to have to see what we can do over here. Just make a ramp which goes in this direction and then straight across. So let's just remove this. This needs to go straight across. I'm going to make another ramp over here, so when that's going like this, even across, join this up. It's not really nice now, is it? Push this straight. There we go. And now we will connect this up somehow. Let's see what we can do. This across up to here and through to there. Yes, that's looking good. Now I'm going to remove this connection from here. Let's remove that for now. Push this straight forward. Let's see how far we can take it without green. Oh, we can do a long one. Okay, so that's exactly what I wanted to see. So I'll push this out to here. This needs to go all the way out to here now. That's not what I wanted to press. From here. No, again, I'm pressing bulldoze. I need to press page down, isn't it? Yes, that's right. So what we need to do is do this segment by segment to keep it at a decent, at a good height, that is. Essentially, I need to push this all the way down to here. And now just join that up to here. I think that's pretty good. But one thing that needs to change is the distance. Like to there. And let's see if we can just swing this around out to here. There we go. I can believe in that. That's definitely very believable. And now I'm just going to swing this out to here. First, I'm going to just push this a little bit further up straight. Continues a similar path. Slightly closer. Like that. Okay. Change this around. Now let's just connect up a ramp which goes over here. We can't connect. No, we can't. I think it's too close. So just push it away a little bit further. First, let's see if we can squeeze in. Can squeeze in something like that over here. Push this down. Join this up over here. Hopefully the angle, oh yes, it is a bit nasty. With this gradient over here messing around with us. Gonna have to reconsider this whole connection a little bit. Unless, let's see if we can make the connection over here. I think this might work. We'll just go up now. Up, and just gonna see now. Let's see if we do a, I think we might have to freeform this a little bit. Out to here. No, we can use the normal curve tool. We should be able to anyway. There we go. It's a bit crazy over here, but this will surely fix our issues. This has to fix our problems that we were having. I have no doubts about it. Alright, let's continue the simulation. So now the trucks that want to come over here for the highway, they're coming here for the highway. And the trucks that want to come take this ramp into this area, they can. So we should have less issues. Okay, I think that solved it. All the areas from within over here have completely cleared up. The last little segments are now just funneling out. And we shouldn't have any more issues. Last thing we now need to do is continue just the... You can see that when we were creating the initial highway, we, to this area, to the connection, we ended up starting off with just a simple connection over here, and they had traffic lights, and after a little bit it started to pile up as this industry started to expand because more trucks decided to come. And then we had to extend and build these ramp, and then the extra additional ramp, and now as you can see, with the constant expansion of this area, we've eventually had to even make more specific ramps just for this area off the main highway. So you can see how as your city expands, you still have to, even though you like what you've made and it should work with this, there's still little little areas that you still have to keep fixing. Because as your city grows, you just, there's too much demand for certain areas. Now look, if I were to create highway connections, three-lane highway connections off the highway, you probably would be able to avoid everything. But I don't like the way that looks. I don't find it very realistic to be able to have three turning lanes onto another highway. However, with ramps, you can have true lane ramps, but it's not involved in the game. But I've never seen three lane turning ramps, so that's why I'm doing individual singular ramps. It looks more realistic. And after all, this is an urban design show, so try to make it look as realistic as possible, while still at the same time making it functional. And this seems to be doing the job absolutely perfectly. So before we finish up, we'll just start filling now all this extra demand that we have for industry. And if worst comes to worst, if this becomes really blocked up, I think we could potentially make it like another ramp which bypasses this industry from this part of the industry, and this road right here, I'm selecting over the top, this road by adding the ramp over here somewhere, so it can kind of bypass everything. But that's if things get really bad. Worst case scenario. But for the time being, everything's going okay. And okay, so now we've got this new connection over here as well, which we made a few episodes ago. I'm seriously now wondering and considering of actually not even making any ramps over here. I don't think, I mean, it would be pretty cool if we could have some ramps here, but just on the basis of how this highway works, I mean, we've got this massive interchange over here. And vehicles know exactly which way they want to go. If they want to go straight and take the long loop around over here to this interchange, or if they want to just take this little loop over here through what will be eventually a neighborhood and out through the tunnel, I don't think vehicles will be changing their mind around over here. So yeah, that's my current thinking process. I might actually add a on and off ramp over here though, so when I build my neighborhood, we actually do have some sort of a connection. But that's as far and as extensive as I will probably make it. Depending later on, maybe that I might make an off ramp over here to make vehicles go in that direction. Because if we're going to have residents over here in this looped up, in this boxed up area, then it will be a good idea, I think, But we'll see. I mean, that's eventually going to happen later. So we'll have to wait and see. To see how things develop, that is. Now, let's say our employment percentage is 96%, so that's good. We don't have much demand for residential, but you know what? Oi, we have a few burned down buildings over here. So just clean them up. Not enough shoppers, or... yeah, needs more customers. So this area is all pretty much nice and good. I will expand here a little bit. Let's just add another small section of road. Like that. And we'll just fill this in like that. And we'll see. I mean, we don't really have any demand for residential at the moment, so... we're sitting pretty. Although, I would like to keep expanding, because I'd like to finish this Velas district completely. But that's just not happening with our... literally no demand for residential. Buildings not functioning over here. We can do a few road upgrades over here. Okay. This highway has a few vehicles coming in, which is good to see. It is actually operating. Another burnt down building. Wow. These fire services around here, yeah, they're not really that great. Might have to move the fire service out a little bit further away. Wherever it is. There it is. Okay. So... let's see what we can do. We don't have it. This fire service is over here, and it covers everything pretty well. Many areas. So, for example, if I were to move this fire service over here, what coverage would I get? Not too bad. I think over there would be a more appropriate spot. Here. Yeah, that looks like the spot that I'd have to place it in. So it's just a small little movement across, but I think that will work better. And so what I'm going to have to do now is that spot that I cleared out over here. This is now going to be, I'm going to clear out these two shops and place this as all residential. Place the fire truck over here, so no, that's slightly off still. Place it right there so that I can still fit a couple of commercial buildings right there. And we've got electrical problems over here. How are we doing with electricity? Oh, we have ramped up electricity production. We're still doing well, but... what's going on? We shouldn't be... okay. Let's go into our budget and into our electricity and increase the funding to 80%. And we should start seeing... yes, less problems with electricity. Wow, we've caught up with electricity pretty quickly. So this dam will start to output a bit more power. That's finished emptying, so let's just start filling. Now this highway area, look at that. This is crazy around over here. This ramp doesn't seem to be struggling with too much traffic. This area seems to be funneling pretty well. This is all very good for the time being. Later on, I think I will have to make a couple of extra on and off ramps around here, but in due time. So we made a little bit of progress, more progress on the basis of just fixing little things around here and there. We're having a little bit of a tough moment over here as well. But even if we do get caught up over here, it's not really going to affect these ramps so much, because it should be able to clear itself out. Yeah. So yeah, very little progress, but progress nonetheless. Because we just simply don't have any demand for residential in order to just properly expand. But before we do, I just want to have a quick look of transport and have a look what the airplane offers. An airport costs 6,000 a week. Yikes. Okay. And that's pretty big. That's not bad, that's decent sized. Now, are we able to see, this is where the airline connection is, right there. I don't think that would be a bad spot to place an airport, right over here. I reckon that'd be pretty good. Place an airport right here. Have it equal with the highway. It's not too far away from the city. I can just bend this road away. Yeah, that could be actually a very, very nice place to connect, because over here this is all starting to get a bit far. We'll have to consider it, and if we do place it, there's definitely going to have to be some sort of highway ramps and connections. So I do want to create a bit of a small industry around, residential area, and I don't want the airport to be too close to that. So something we're definitely going to have to think about. I think it would be a very nice spot right here. If we do place it, we're going to have to turn it off, because we're not going to be connecting it essentially straight away. Alright guys, so I'm going to end this episode, and I'm thinking what we're going to do is next episode. Now I can see that the more industry that we've been placing, we're going to have some more demand for residential. So that's what we're going to try and fix. And maybe as well, I'm thinking maybe we can start working on some of these highways as well while we're waiting for like our demand of certain areas to increase. We can work on our highways a little bit and think about future expansions and what to do. So guys, hit that subscribe button, because I think we've got a few exciting episodes coming ahead. So for now, take care. I'll see you all very soon. Bye bye.